Nate Goyard.
We love you, bud.
Stay with me, little bitch, yeah, you know that.
Quick disclaimer, in the tutorial, you'll see that the effect looks a little different. That's because I changed some stuff after I actually recorded that. The editing process is pretty much the exact same, so you don't gotta worry about any changes. Your effect will come out exactly like the intro. Just ignore the fact that it looks a little different in the tutorial. Alright guys, welcome back to another tutorial. Today I'm gonna be teaching you how to do this really cool like rainbow character glow effect that you guys saw in the intro. And yeah, let's get straight into it. Alright, so I already have my song and my clip in here. I'm using One and Only Stay With Me, and I'm using my own clip. And the first thing I would start off with usually is time remapping and, you know, the speed ups and slowdowns. And I've done that multiple times in the past, so if you guys really want to see that, go check out my other two videos. And it's pretty much the same setup in this one. So now once you have your clip time remapped, let's start with the effect. So right on the point where your slow-mo starts, so for me it's right here, you want to split your clip, Control Shift D, and then duplicate it, Control D. And on this top clip, you're gonna wanna create a very rough mask using your pen tool up here, just around your character. It does not have to be perfect at all, it could be very rough, just like this. And once you have your mask figured out, it's all around your character, you're gonna wanna open down the little side menu right here into your mask. And turn your feather up a lot. Turn it up to about 80, I'd say. And you can see that kind of just keeps your character out of focus. And you can see that makes your mask look a little nicer. You maybe want to mess with the mask expansion a little bit. And yet again, it doesn't have to look good at all. This looks pretty bad, but you'll see what will happen later on. Oh yeah, and also I forgot to say, trim it right when the speed up starts. So for me, that is about right there. So you want to cut it so your top clip is just this little part, and that's your mask. And make sure it tracks your character throughout it. If your character moves a little bit, then you might want to track your mask, but for me it's pretty simple, so you can just keep it the same. It's all depends on your clip. All right, and then once you have your mask finished up on this top clip right here, you can go ahead and add my preset, which I of course will leave in the description. Now once you add my preset, you'll see that the effect is already there, but you might have to move around some keyframes. These two keyframes right here are supposed to be at the end of your mask, so just move them over to them, just like that. Just make sure your hue, set bright, is right where I told you. What you might want to do is add my other preset, which I will provide in the description once again. Once you add it to your background or your bottom clip, you can go ahead and adjust the keyframes. You just want to have these two keyframes at the end of your clip. So for me, it's right here. Just like that, and you can see the effect is already taking place. But you can see it's kind of abrupt right here, so to kind of make that fade in, all you want to do is go open the tab right here, go to transform, keyframe your opacity, go about 10 frames forward, create another keyframe, go to the very first one, set it to 0. You can see it fades in just like that, very clean. You can see your effect already looks really nice here. But I did add one more thing, which was an overlay, which I will also provide in the description. And this is a very simple overlay, it's just rising particles. And what you want to do is put it in between your two clips. So this is your mask right here, this is your background clip, you want to put it in between those. You can adjust it just like that. And you'll see that it blocks out your background. So you want to go ahead and change this to screen, so it'll cut out the black, and there you go. Now you have your particles rising. You want to cut that out right when the impact happens. And to kind of give the particles that rainbow tint to it, what you go ahead and do is add glow, sapphire glow. Might want to mess with the settings a little. This is an extra, this is not needed. You might want to mess with it a bit. and then go ahead and add hue set, right? And just do a hue shift. Go a different pace, man, I'm on a plane, man, I can't complain, first class game, too much money gain, bought a new chain, ignorant ways, ignorance of bliss, smile on my face, mama just pray, grandma just pray, grandma wanna call, wanna switch lanes, for my birthday, I want more than you, babe, fuck you any day, make you scream my name, I got deja vu. There you see. Now the particles have that rainbow effect to them too. And one last extra you could do is add an adjustment layer, and having it zoom into your character looks really clean. You want to add blur mode curves. Once you have blur mode curves, you want to start keyframing. So I'd say right about where your slow-mo begins to start, keyframe your Z distance and rotate. Now open this up. You want to go a couple frames forward to where your effect comes in. So I'd say for me it's about right here. It's when it starts changing colors and stuff. You want to create another two keyframes. Keyframe your Z distance down to about, I'd say 0.6 looks nice. And move your center to focus on your character. So for me, I'm just gonna move it down and up like that. You can see it's my character's in focus. You wanna add a little bit of a rotation too. Now you can see this black is kinda peeking through. All you gotta do is go to your wrap X and Y, put that to reflect, and that's gone now. You can see your character zooms in just like that. Now you wanna add your keyframes at the end so it doesn't stay like this forever. So for me it's right here. What you could do is a really simple tip. Control C these, copy and paste these over here, move them, select them again, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse. This just pretty much does it for you, just like that. Now these look really linear and not very good, so you want to ease these. Go into your graph editor. Go to speed graph, and you just want to drag this little yellow line all the way, and drag this other yellow line all the way to the left, so it's like very fast.
Neat go yard.
Just like that, it looks very smooth. And you want to do the same to these keyframes at the end. F9, go into your graph editor. And this time I'm going to drag it all the way to the right. Make sure you keep it in the center. And now your zoom in should look really clean. Now all you got to do is add in your impact, which I will also give you a free preset for. It's a very clean impact. See, it fits in just right there. And that is pretty much your whole effect done. Alright, that's it for the video, guys. Thank you for the overwhelming support on my first tutorial. Did not expect it to get over 2,000 views at the time of the recording, that's what it's at. But I hope you guys like this effect too. Make sure to let me know in the comments, drop a like, drop a sub. Make sure you follow my Twitter and Instagram too down in the description. And I'll talk to you guys later. Stamina off of that bit all night, which you better not mirror. Cause she ain't lower pipe, yo. Pass her to the squad.